And we are no drop friends. So, good morning, bonjour. Welcome everyone to today's live stream, more low-level hardware programming. Some more bits to share. And initially I would not have even shared this. Normally I would not have shared this, but last night I thought I quickly get this real hardware, real Silicon S3 Trio 64 to work with our bare metal stuff, and it did not just work. So this is why I wanted to quickly share some details I found there. So let's see. So because this was already working, let's see, can we currently run this in DOSBox? And we can, but it doesn't do much. So what this should do, what you've seen last time, I heavily modified this right now last night, is that this should draw a rectangle here and BLT here, this quadrant of the frame buffer to this quadrant. And it was working on in DOSBox and also with the S3 Verge. Of course, for S3 Verge, we have here different code passes. So we have here S3 fill and S3 Verge fill. And on real hardware, it was not doing much. It was even hanging and crashing. And I also don't like this display flickering, but whatever. And I spare you the hours of searching. And so Trio. The problem was also that I partially was working with this PDF that I found somewhere in the dark corners of the internet. And you can too. So if you want to do this code of stuff, then you usually just find something with Google. Because I was looking, by the way, is this OCRt or text? Version art is even text, because not all of the documents I should have OCRt them with our OCR. So the problem was I was working with this specification and this does not match the hardware. So also one point to look out. So the big problem here, I can tell you after some hours of searching on this last night, and this is also why I probably will not live stream everything, because it was extremely boring even for me. So I guess it's better to live stream summaries or pre-edited videos. But as usual, leave me in the comments below what you think. Ah, here we are getting somewhere. So the problem is that this hardware, so this is an real Trio, S3 Trio 64, and this spec is for a Trio 64 V+. And this V+ apparently has some new features and goodies in town there. And this is why I was programming here for stuff that the silicon would not do. And this usually takes in quite some hours to find until you realize, wait a second, some of this stuff does not add up. And what is not adding up is that this, so this is new MMIO, and I thought all of those Trio 64, 32 would do this new MMIO, because you can access this programmed IO stuff here in different ways. This, I think even some of those should also work like this, should also work with old-fashioned IO ports that of course normally you would not want to use because it's really inconvenient. At least this is why I think it is written IO address, and I think I saw in PC emulator that it is implementing IO port access, at least I think. So you can probably bit bang here this IO ports with it, and this should probably work, but of course that we would not want to do this. What I have used this also for the S3 Verge, where this is similar, and this works in DOSBox because probably it implements Trio 64 5+. And exactly this is not working on this hardware. Specifically here, this is the 32 linear address here of this, because if you have seen the previous videos, we love linear addressing, because otherwise the VGA address was banked in some tiny 64K window, and then you would always in real mode fill the 64K segment, even in protected mode if you wanted to, and would have to bank switch there to address the 1 MB or so of VGA memory. Or 256 or 512 of earlier VGA cards. So the big problem of this, which wasted me an hour or two, is that this silicon there is not implementing here this enhanced registers and stuff in this kind of linear addressing, and I only realized after comparing a lot of data and values and writing them all over the place. And where did I move this file now? Best preparation, as usual. S3 should be probably have this here somewhere. Not trio, but another trio. Or did I not copy this over? Maybe I should have copied this over. Anyway, then I show you how to find this also on the internet. So this is Trio 64. This was on some VGA museum site. And there it was called datasheet, I think. You see here probably, actually maybe not this, but let's download this and see what we get. Always interesting to get new documents. This looks about right. Let's also save this here with some save button. Which of this would this be? This probably. So let's see what we get here on this document. Probably, or does it have actually, it looks like it has text. Interesting. So let's see what this is specifying this document. Because you will see, let's see, what did we get here? You see here this linear addressing table is missing in this document. And also, so you always need to read the specifications very carefully and look out that you look the exactly matching one. Because in this one you see that it is writing, which fan is running here? Like this Mac Mini or? Okay, it looks like we are overheating the Mac Mini. By the way, are we still? Do we have DOSBox open? No, we don't have DOSBox open. Of course, overheating already because amazing Apple thermal design quality. Anyway, so SA right here accesses to the enhanced command registers are made to particular locations in A800 hex to AFFF hex address range as shown in table 13.1. Table 13.1, of course, being this, similar to what I've shown earlier. And there you probably should always read each sentence and number carefully because, wait a second, what does it mean with 8A000? Are we not having this memory mapped in our amazing 4 or 2 megabyte linear frame buffer address? So there we see the development of VGA stuff. Initially, they have not always done this the way the modern card do this. So there you see the development. First, they had this IO port programmed, of course, also in the earlier cards. So this Trio 32 and 64 are already newer. Before that were other numeric named accelerators or whatsoever. This 8.3, what is this here? Is it written here? 8.3, whatever, something. You get the idea, probably here it's still maybe somewhere. Whatever the numbers was, doesn't really matter. So first they were doing all this bit BLT line drawing programming with I.O. ports. You would just fill this values here into this I.O. ports. And then only later they memory mapped this. And where did they memory map this first? They memory mapped this into the regular VGA window, of course, slightly inconvenient. So after I read this, I last night, of course, had to go through my program and adapt the code here. So now we have IO base. We had here some IO base that was naturally some high PCI Visa local bus address, of course. And now we have here some, since last night I added here some detection to old MMIO, of course, default false. And then we switch here already anyway or based on some S3 registers to determine which card we have. And if this is Trio 32 and 64, then we set here old MMIO. Not sure about the others, maybe some more, but I don't have them. And then if this is old MMIO, another trick that we do here already, because this Visa frame buffer BIOS extension thing is too old, only version 1.2 or something, because we set here this linear bit. And of course this errors out on this hardware. Actually, it works in DOSBox, but on the real BIOS, it doesn't work. And if this doesn't work, then we try only with this no clear bit set and not the linear bit. And then as with the S3 Verge, because even the S3 Verge didn't have VBE, Weser BIOS Extension 2 or so for linear windowing, linear addressing. We enable this ourselves here. And also I, just for the safety, because this S3 Verge has here a bit new MMIO, and this is of course reserved on this older hardware. And due to this, I also tweaked this code to just set these bits on the new hardware, not if this is old MMIO, just to be on the safe side, because I had this even hanging, like right now I had to reboot this. By the way, maybe we check that we have actually something running there. Yeah, we do. And so just to be safe, not to set the reverse bits. And then if this is old MMIO, because this IO base usually is this very high 100 something, in very high in this linear frame buffer here. You see here whatever that is in megabytes, something very high. And of course we need to change this now. And because we have here this unreal pointer to address a linear frame buffer that is then at the very high address, something like hundreds of megabyte range, FF or CC or something like that, whatever the card is programmed for, we read this out here on this IO port. And due to this, I trick this here, because I actually have here this unreal pointer. And this is unreal pointer here. This has already some base, so we are not addressing in the physically zero-based memory of the wheel system, but for convenience to allow addressing the linear frame buffer, so to draw from the very first pixel here, I have here already some base offset to set the base offset to the whatever the linear address was here, what we got here, FF or CC or whatever, very high hundreds of megabytes address, if not gigabyte, last gigabyte or whatever, depending on the card. So we need to change this offset here, this IO base, relative to this physical base. This is why we cannot just set this to A0000. This wouldn't work, because this would be in the linear address, high in the address range, 3 gigabyte or something, and in the linear frame buffer plus A00. This would of course be just some pixel here. So we need to subtract all the physical base pointer for this to complement logic, kind of overflowing this as a subtraction there, and actually then really address in the lowest real mode, kind of, not really something to do with real mode, but just to say it slang wise. So here, also had here some testing, because this did not just immediately work. And so I did here some memory filling, because then I wanted to see if we write here really into this A00. Had to do some trial and error and stuff. And for this, I disabled this old MMIO to really write the pixel data that eventually worked then. And so actually right now I'm not sure why this hangs. So this is a big point. So this older S3 cards, if you write your own DOS demos, vintage demos, retro demos, all of those cards are different. You cannot rely that some S3 Verge is that way, and then all the Trio whatsoever are the same. They changed their stuff in each generation, as much experience they gained there, and probably themselves found this inconvenient writing the Windows driver and stuff like this. So yeah. And then, so this still doesn't work. And the next thing, because this was hanging and I had to always hard boot here with a screwdriver, pressing the reset pins there. And do I have even the scene set up here? I think so. So then I had to do more testing and figure out why this is hanging. And eventually I then figured that this, because I was also reading this command register here for waiting for the engine idle, because usually you should only program this accelerator when it is done doing something, because bit BLTing here, the whole screen over, takes some fractions of a second. So during this time you should probably usually not touch the accelerator registers there or overfill the FIFO, because it has only some 16 or so entries and some FIFO first in, first out buffer. And this was hanging, of course. This also took some 30 minutes to pinpoint where this actually is hanging, and it was hanging here reading this packed MMIO addresses. And I was only using this because they say here, so again you need to be careful what spec we read. This is 3032/64, and even in this they already say, for improved performance most of the enhanced mode registers can also be written but not read via pack configuration. The 16-bit registers are paired so that two registers can be accessed via the single 32-bit write. The address for the packed configuration are given in table 13.1, so this table we were looking at earlier already. And I did not really pay attention to this, and I think this probably worked in the S3 Verge. By the way, very theoretically, we could look up if this is in the Verge spec. If we would have it here, there we have wherever. So much crap in the meantime that I don't have this. Is it even Verge or to delete this or if I have done to this anyway? So this is appears a problem. I overread this. This also works in the Verge. Not sure if they have written this there. And I then changed this. So for this to test, I had to change here our enum with symbolic values here. As I said earlier, I used this packed stuff for performance and convenience because with this packed stuff, so basically what this means, they have all those registers, this acceleration registers like current X and Y and stuff. They have this here with I/O ports as well as memory mapped I/O at this address as well. And then also additionally newly packed. So of course slightly inconvenient that everything is accessible in three different means and then some are hanging and not working. And then for a test, I changed this. You see here with comments, this were the previous ones. And I changed a couple of more. For example, this for example, I added because previously I only had here this alt current xy. I typed here the same alt current xy that were here in the spec. This is why I didn't even had current y and x as single symbolics here. So I changed this and lo and behold with this it actually does something. And this is where I went home last night and continue now with you here. But this is already everything you need to know because now it starts to work. And this is also why hardware driver development is expensive. Also we want to start our Gartling here already. If we probably have run it like this yesterday. And so this is the S3 Verge and all this stuff, because here you see right now it's hanging, not really sure why it's hanging, not really sure if I left it like this, but actually, wait a second, somehow, or is it only hanging because we don't have a mouse driver or something? I thought the mouse driver was working actually, because it's not hanging. As you see there, we have here some register read and probably also want to have the camera view here. So we have here some, but this is not the way I wanted. How many camera setups do we have here now? Maybe this. So as you see there, we have there, I overlooked this, not really sure why we don't have mouse cursor moving, or is this now the mouse cursor moves. Why did it not move earlier? Now it's hanging. Something is slightly strange here. No idea why right now. But we are not done with this anyway. Not sure if this is related to the video capture because yesterday it wasn't like this. Anyway, so this white rectangle there is already an improvement that we did not have before. As I said before, we had nothing. Obviously, we were writing into the linear frame buffer where no memory mapped I/O register things were living in this older generation. And so if this is true, next I would need to test, because yesterday I changed here all of those writes to this registers, to this oscillator registers. And actually, if this is true that it can be written just not but not read, then because we usually do not read those back, we would only read this command thing here. And it's of course a little bit annoying also that you can't, if you use this new packed MMIO, then you can write it, but if you want to read something like the command engine FIFO status thing, then you need to use an old one, slightly a little bit meh in the code, but whatever gasket is what we get with using old and vintage hardware. Because next we probably can, so this was fill, we can undo most of this and actually see if this would still work. And because this weight engine, maybe we try to enable this and modify it in a way so that it works. Oh, wait a second, they have, by the way, here, the only thing that helps a little bit, they have here some engine status that was something like GP something status. I think it was probably mentioned here in all of those code examples. By the way, I find it a little bit funny that they use x86 assembly stuff and even remote setup here, so ES extra segment index with alt mix. Slightly funny in my opinion. This comes from an era where just DOS programming was the norm. Where is now, or was a searchable GPU a GP status, GPU status. Here's our GP stat. And this is the only thing that helps us here with S3, because otherwise the command, when we want to write this command register, we would, because this is also the same register number, if you write it, it's command, if you read it, it's graphic processor status. So like with our edit card, where we could only read and write one control register thing and had to shadow it and cache it and couldn't read it back. So this is the only thing that is helping here. You see 9AE8, this is the same here. And if we want to change this over command to this new packed register index, we could leave this there, and because we only read GP stat and write this command. So GP stat and then S3 weight engine here, status is our status bit, and get 16 of not CMD but GP stat. And this could theoretically work. We also right now have debug code here, debug at line 3 on the screen, and then sprint, as we have our own C library like setup here, relatively nice to do. In my opinion, much nicer than writing DOS assembly here, and much nicer reusable if we soon move this to some own OS demo thing. Can just reuse all this code here without any worries. So this should probably work, I think. And then we have to clean up all this mess that we made yesterday with debugging all over the place there, modifying everything left and right. And as usual, if you have any comments, would like to hear in your chat, always nicer to have some dynamic here, some conversation. So let's see, this is this, and then we have our Ethernet card from our MTCP setup on DOS from the other live stream, and can see what we get here. Not found, that is not good. Ah, I have run the SCART links, and we probably have executed some garbage and need to reboot. So scuttling in the right object directory and the whole stuff again. But the round trip time of edit, compile, execute is pretty fast in this setup. This is why I like this much more than tinkering in the Linux kernel. And somehow we have, what have we done now? This is really strange. Maybe this is after all some hiccup of the capturing card, or what have we? Don't know, can't really imagine that this is related. This is to reuse our capture card and then we get this chaos. Still need, or should have tried some splitter thing there. So much for not having tried this S3 weight engine. I want to stream it perfectly, and all we get is imperfect video capture. Always some learning experience with the equipment, once it works, once it doesn't. Let's see what this does. Work, why should this white engine stuff? Actually, it could theoretically be that we still crashed. This is exactly, maybe we really crashed this and this didn't work. GP stat, how many bits were this? This are 16 bits. You see all the engine busy, slots empty, stuff like that. Should this still crash? Because when this capture device doesn't get, maybe this was flickering like this because I had this already with switching this PC off, then it flickers similarly with previously captured frames or something in the USB buffer there of this Epiphan thing. So I had here code, I think, from last night, printing out bare registers and trying here, let's for a test try to read just this. So this is, what was our status, was 9AE8, 9AEA, what? Oh, this is, wait a second, no, A, this is command register 2, what am I printing there? Yeah, command register 2, why would I even print that though? 9EA8, and okay, this is already, but then reading this should work. Why does this again not work? Always some surprises when we live stream here. 9AE. It was already what we print out. Let's see what. But then this reading should work. Actually, wait a second, why is this again completely distorted? Slightly puzzled by this result, S3. Wait. 8-bit, second bit here, this is, so this are 8 bits, and then the second bit, hardware busy, should be bit 9, hardware busy, 0 is not busy. So there should be this bit, read the status, get 16 IO based GP stat. Did we have a typo in GP stat? Oh, wait a second. Did I 9A? No, this is 9AE8. Read only 9AE8. 9AE8. Probably I need to plug this into the display that I see this without flickering, what is actually going on there. Oh, I think I... But we get here the bit 4 set, so this is... It looks right, why would this not work if we call S3 fill S3? S3 white engine debug line. Okay, let's probably print this later. 200 should not be set. So start with this bit set until 52nd, maybe this is only 8 bits shifted to the... maybe that is an issue here, some infinite loop actually. Because we want bit 9. Then we should better also shift to bit 9. Something slightly strange regarding the capture here. Besides, so now we indeed wait. So then this probably works, and I probably can. I only wonder why is our some drop frames, but not many. Why is my fan going to full speed here? Wonders of Apple thermal design qualities. So, which camera for you? Yeah, if you're in the chat, leave me a line in the chat. What you think about all this, what you want to know, if you learn something. I hope you learn something, and also I inspire you to do low-level stuff, because I have the feeling most people nowadays only do HTML5 and stuff, and few people, well, at least not that many people learn how to actually do the real programming and not the colorful programming. So, okay, this bug also fixed, S3 Vade. Then we can change our, because we heavily modified this, I usually just take a look with SVN then here, because I modified all of this here. As you see, we want to reverse half of this also. We want to modify this function here back to use the original setup, because I had here, for example, right here current xy is this here. So we want, for of course, the balance is now, if we want to have this work with even older cards, we could use the even older IO registers there for compatibility. But right now I don't want to change here so much. You see, I also added here some new stuff. The scissor, by the way, means clipping. Don't, by the way, personally don't like the scissor name. Also probably G Allen stuff. I prefer clip. But whatever, they name it scissor, then I name it scissor. By the way, there's also a typo in this spec. First I typed this in there, and scissors has here a typo, at least in the other document it had. Yeah, I see it already here. You see here is a typo. I also had this even already in ISO standard, so I know in some ISO standards also typos like this. So this, of course, because I typed this in here and then the compiler said the scissors R is already used, and obviously this is top left bottom right, so this is a typo there. It's not R but L, but just the regular stuff you find on data sheets. And with that being said, let's finish here this stuff. We could, by the way, let's try to enable the BitBLT, remove this return that I had here. This could probably work. No, I guess we only set here stuff. Let's see what happens if we copy this over. By the way, did I switch over to the other camera scene? Yeah, somehow I really wonder why this, not only the mouse is not... Wait a second, why? Slightly strange, whatever happens there with the capture and stuff. Okay, this does not look the very best. Actually, maybe this is really crashed now, because as you see, this is blinking blue. This means it does not have a video signal. It should be green. If it has a signal now, it's green, as you are flickering, so Control-Alt-Delete, so this Heavy blinking, so some probably, oh, bit BLT stuff is not yet working. Fill was working, I think. Need to check that way. But yeah, this is not different with modern hardware, only modern hardware is more complicated if you do AMD and NVIDIA, Intel stuff. And then of course things made harder without any datasheet available. Object dir. Let's see, I commented this out. Let's maybe try the line. Also doesn't work as, and if it flickers like this, then as you see, this thing doesn't have a signal. It's of course a really interesting crash indicator, not really sure. But if this, but we could actually still quit this. This is slightly strange. Or we hang, or this hangs really the, it's really strange, I really wonder. But what we do here now is only wait for the only thing we enabled is actually line is actually lucky line is enabled. Let's return here also. I usually this is a very quick thing to disable their function for testing. Hey, look at this, we even got lines there from, this is why I do not clear the screen actually, because then I have there not only bit pattern for orientation, what kind of stuff we get, but there you see the leftover from the last run is actually some lines, so this actually worked. Are there all lines? Maybe. So you see we make progress here, not sure why this capture thing quit like this then. But you get the idea. The biggest point was we can't read this registers, the SPECT registers back here in this S3. So always look out for the such catches there in the spec. And the next thing was that we also had to do this in another memory mapped IO region. And also PC emulator and DOSBox are not as closely emulating this, so it is, while it is really nice to work with PC emulator and such also for on the go, then by the way, why is this blinking? Should this not, I get confused here with what this should show or not. What do we get here? But somehow this is not updating, so this actually is showing 2 frames. This is probably what the somehow is capturing here, something strange and not right now. You see, this is why this is not, the frame ticker there is not incrementing. This is really strange. I wonder why this so much to this VGA capture here. Yeah, now it's green, whatever. Strange stuff. Yeah, as usual, I hope you enjoyed this real world coding episode here and learned something. I for sure learned